Hi there, and welcome to this month's edition of For the Love of Animals. I'm Carlotta, the co-founder and president of Humane Haven Animal Shelter. And today I will be introducing you to some of our homeless dogs available for adoption. And I just want to remind you as you meet them, they have been with us for quite some time now, and they are patiently waiting for their forever home. All right, let's bring out our first adoptable pet. All right, this is Ali, and Ali, A-L-I, is a Jack Russell mix. And again, we can never say for sure what a breed of dog is because we're usually just guessing most of the time to the best of our knowledge with our experience and dealing with breeds. But he pretty much looks like a Jack Russell to us, pretty much the bright size and all. Ali is about 3 years old, and don't know if you've watched the show months past, but he came to us with some history that we knew that he had been abused in his past, and we knew that when he came to Humane Haven that we were going to need to have a patient hand, that he might be with us for some time, and that, you know, right away he wouldn't be able to go on our adoption page. And that was fine with us, because when we make a commitment to a pet, our commitment is to make sure we are with them until they are adopted, whether it be for medical reasons or mental stability reasons for him. It's trust issues right now, because the humans had let him down in the past. So we have been working with this wonderful little boy, and he has been very lucky to be able to stay with one of our volunteers who has been working with him in a training regard, which is called desensitization. And with a little boy who is reactive, unfortunately reactive in a sense where he wants to snap, because that is the first and most common defense mechanism a frightened dog will use, is snapping. You want to desensitize them to, you know, things that they're reacting to, and unfortunately he reacts to anything that startles him. So we're trying to desensitize them to loud noises, fast motion. And one thing he was very afraid of, we noticed in the beginning, was men. And we knew from his past that that was where most of his abuse had come from. So we also have been trying to have a lot of men visit with our little man here, and he is doing great. So progress report for Ali is he is doing great, but he will need, we believe, a more quiet family. We don't believe that Ali will probably ever want to progress into a very, you know, very, very active, loud party type of right family. Like right now he's thinking, why are you talking so much? And why are the bright lights on me? And those cameras are scary. It's a very scary place right now. And he actually just came from adoption, so he's had a lot for one afternoon. So he is, or I should say, the ideal forever home for this little guy would probably be a quiet home. I would recommend that it not have small children running around the home, grabbing for toys, or just not understanding that they might need to be more gentle with Ali. More or older children, more mature, that would be able to understand maybe what he has gone through and why they might need to be gentle and not grab at him and be slower and, you know, understand. So that's really all he needs. He's not a bad boy. He's scared. And look at how small he is. He lives in such a large world that has let him down by abusing him, which is horrible. You know, I just don't understand why anybody or anyone would need to harm an 8-pound animal beyond my ever knowing. So he's doing great. Our progress report is good. Ali's coming along, and with all our loving, tender care, that's all he needs. And as long as that continues, he is going to turn out to be a very loving little dog. That's all he needs, is consistent love. It's all he needed from the beginning, and he would have never had to learn to trust again to the level of his having to learn to trust right now. It's just not right. Right, buddy?
Right.
I know. So this is Ali. Again, Jack Russell, 3 years old. He doesn't need a fenced-in yard, but always will need to be on leash. And again, probably not the little dog that's going to want to go shopping at PetSmart or taken with you. Might want to be taken with you for rides in the car, but not necessarily taken in with you to busy locations. He definitely wants to hang with you and have a companion all the time, but really active areas right now are not his thing. But right now are not his thing. Maybe he'll come into that. Who knows, right? Who knows? But he's getting there. All right. We hope that Ali's forever family is out there. Patience is a virtue for that forever family. But we have patience here at Humane Haven, and we know you're out there. So if you'd like to come out and meet him, please do. He's a wonderful little man. Thank you for joining us this episode. Remember, before you come out to adoptions, make sure you call ahead to make sure the adoptable dog you would like to meet is at the adoption center. And as you start your search for your new family pet, also remember to take your time in making that very important decision. Don't rush into things just because there is a cute, cuddly puppy. It has to be the right match for you. On that same note, don't expect to have an immediate bond as well. In a adoption atmosphere, in a pet store atmosphere, the adoptable pets are usually pretty nervous. So the pets that you're meeting in that atmosphere most of the time are not the pets that you will have as your forever pet. The pet that you end up with will all depend on you and how you raise them, how you love them, and how you teach them how to behave. All right, well, good luck with your search and finding that right family pet for you, and we'll see you next time.
Welcome to the cat segment of For the Love of Animals. We're very happy to have you with us today, and we have a lot of new kitties we want you to meet. And we want you to meet Jason, one of our volunteers, and he's here to help us with this kitty. Now, first of all, Jason, who is this?
This is Winston.
Okay. He's a handsome guy. Oh, my goodness. But he's being kind of shy here. He hasn't been in the studio before, and so he's hiding, or he thinks he is, aren't you? Hi. Hi, cutie. I love black cats. Yes, I do. Now, you feel free, Jason, to put him down if you want to, because I can see he's trying to escape. But maybe he'll just lay here a little bit, and we can... maybe he'll pay attention to us. Maybe he won't, okay? But anyway, Winston is a domestic short hair, okay? He's about 3 years old, and he was a stray, but he is no more. He is now a member of Humane Haven. And so if you're looking for a handsome cat, you might want to consider this guy. Male cats tend to get along better with other males. Would you agree?
Yes.
Okay. And they can get along with females, but, so you got to be careful if you're bringing a second cat into your home. But first of all, I want to talk to Jason about a few things. Okay. Okay. How long have you been with us now, Jason, as a volunteer?
I have been with Humane Haven for 7 years. I started in August of 2010.
Oh, wonderful. Mm-hmm. I wonder how many of our volunteers remember even how long they've been here. It's been an eternity, right? But 7 years. That's terrific. Now, how many times a week do you volunteer?
I volunteer once a week.
Okay.
I go into the shelter facility, and I work on Sunday afternoons.
Uh-huh.
So usually while you're here taping, I'm off socializing and doing some care for the kitties that we have at the shelter.
Okay.
I start at around 3:30 in the afternoon, and then I usually work with a partner, and we do generally what is called a socializer shift. So
okay, what does that involve?
We go in and we take out each of the cats and give them some playtime, let them stretch their legs and give them some enrichment and stimulus and attention and socialization. And we also do very minor work on making sure that their cages are tidy, that they've got fresh water. If there's anybody that's on any medication because they just had a surgery, or anything like that, we make sure that they get that if they have a PM dosing. But okay. mostly I get to play with cats, and that's what I get to do.
That's a really hard job, isn't it?
Oh, it's tough, I tell you.
Okay, now you have a couple cats at home?
I do, we have four.
Okay.
And they're all alumni from Humane Haven.
Oh, isn't that great? Yeah.
Two of them are little black parlor panthers, just like Winston here.
Oh, really?
And three of them ended up being special needs, but we love them anyways. And we take good care of them, and we know that when they were at the shelter, because we got to meet them before they really were introduced to the general public, we know that they were taken care of very, very well.
Yeah. Now, I'm told, I think this was the right guy, well, one of them anyway, that we're going to show you today, likes chin rubs and ear rubs and that kind of thing. I think a lot of cats do, don't they?
Yeah, a lot of them like attention.
Oh, look at this. Look at this guy.
Yep.
He was ready to take our hand off a minute ago.
Yeah, he's just soaking up the pets. He's he really enjoys those.
He likes
the head scritches. A lot of them enjoy space behind the ears here, long cheeks.
Right. Okay. So... okay, so you've been doing the same job since you started, is that correct?
I actually have two jobs with the shelter.
Okay.
So I've been doing the socializer job since August of 2010.
Okay.
And then in September of 2011, I believe it was, I was asked to step up and chair our IT committee.
Okay.
So things like our website, our Twitter account, our phone system, things like that are all areas that I've lent a hand and tried to either make the experience more enjoyable or easier for our potential adoptive families or lower costs so that we can put more money into the care of our animals.
Right, right. Yeah. Okay, and you've been doing an excellent job, too.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. okay, so what else do we want everybody to know? You can volunteer with us. Have we said that before on some previous show? We're always looking for more
volunteers.
Yeah.
It's so easy. It's not a big commitment. Like I said, for the socializer work that I've been doing, it's once a week. I'm putting in an hour and a half. I can go in generally whatever time in the afternoon, take as long as I need. It accommodates my schedule.
Okay.
Oh, you're purring. You really do like that attention, don't you?
Yeah, he does.
And it's so easy. PetSmart, we need volunteers as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, at both facilities, but you will volunteer at one or the other. You won't switch back and forth usually. Now, at our shelter facility, which is where you volunteer, okay, we also have kittens, and that's...
a lot of kittens. It's a lot of fun.
A lot of kittens. We probably have more than 20 kittens right now, 18 or 20, something like that.
I think we've got 9 at the shelter by itself.
Yeah.
The facility.
But anyway, so we have lots and lots of kittens, and that means when Jason is there, he's got to take those kittens out of a cage and set up the cage again because they've destroyed it, and feed them because kittens get fed twice a day.
Yep.
Yeah.
And they get lots of socialization, right? So we want to make sure that they're familiar with people, that they trust and enjoy being around people.
Right.
And that's part of the importance of the socialization shift as well.
Absolutely. So when you get a cat from us, you aren't just getting a cat that we just happened to have and just brought in or something. You're getting a cat that's been handled a lot, hopefully, and that has learned to like people, we hope. Okay?
We have so many that when they come to us either from another rescue or from like an animal control facility in the area, they're... I don't know what it is that we luck out. We get a lot of them that are just so friendly out of the box.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
They're so
friendly. That's true.
And they have so much personality.
Oh, look at you. You are shedding because you are so on edge. Yes, but you're such a good boy. No. You're going to stay right here, baby. Okay? Yeah.
We want to make sure that every animal, we understand its personality, whether it gets along with other pets, other cats, dogs.
Right.
How does it feel around loud noises? So maybe the young children might not be the best. They might want an older, quiet home.
Right.
you know, whether they want to be an only cat or whether they're bonded with a litter mate or another yeah. friend that they
or
made at the shelter.
If they'll even be good at, with another cat. We try mm-hmm. to test them somewhat, but we can't always tell because we don't know what your other cat at home is like. So yeah. we do the best we can with that. We try to test them with dogs. When we're at PetSmart, we have the cats in a cage, and we see if we walk a dog by closely, what happens. Mm-hmm. If the cat, you know, bares its teeth and starts screeching, then we know this cat will not be good around dogs.
Sometimes we find out whether they're a bush cat or a tree cat.
That's true. Do you want to describe them?
Yeah. So there's a very famous gentleman named Jackson Galaxy, mm-hmm. and he is kind of the cat equivalent of the dog whisperer. Mm-hmm. And he describes cats as two different types. Bush cats, where they like to be low to the ground, and they tend to be they don't tend to be up high. They don't want to jump on your counters and things like that. And then there's tree cats, and they're the ones that like to be up high, and they mm-hmm. like to be up in trees, and they want to be on the back of your sofa. And sometimes they want to be on your shoulder when you're at the computer.
Yes, yes, that too, yes. And they want lots of attention.
Yes.
A lot of cats do want lots of attention. So, yes, toys are great. You know, now if he were in a less strenuous, a different environment, yeah.
A home environment where he was comfortable.
He will play with toys mm-hmm. and run around with them and stuff. Here, not so much. He just got here into the building where we're taping the show, and he has no clue why he's here. And sometimes we wonder, too. But anyway, he's a wonderful cat. Mm-hmm. I think we said at the beginning he's about 3 years old.
Yep.
Okay.
Really enjoys petting.
Yes. And look, he likes that toy now, too.
Yeah, a lot of them like string toys.
Oh, yeah, they do. They do.
Gives them something to chase and hunt.
Right, right. So think about it. If you're thinking of getting another cat and you're thinking of a young cat, now 3 years is young. Many cats these days live to be 18 or 20 years old. Mm-hmm. So 3 years old, you're going to have him for a long time.
Yeah.
And he is a nice cat. He is a very nice cat.
Yeah, he's really enjoying his pets.
Yes, his name is Winston. We've had him for a few weeks. That's about all. He is microchipped. He is neutered. He has his distemper and rabies shots, as all our cats do. We do the registration of the microchips. We just have you fill in a paper.
I got it.
Okay. And anyway, so we make it as easy for you as possible, and we make sure everything is done for the animal. If you have any questions, that or something you aren't sure about, you can call us at 630-378-4208. Press 2 for cats, and someone will call you back. You can leave your name and phone number there, please. Don't just leave a message. Leave your name and phone number, too. And if you have questions, ask the questions, or just say you'd like to speak to someone about a cat. That would be fine. And we will call you back, and hopefully we'll be able to connect you with an animal that will make you very happy. What do you think?
Well, I've done it 4 times now, so I think we have a pretty good trend going.
I think so. And I think Winston is a very nice cat, aren't you? Oh, yes. And you would like to play with somebody, wouldn't you? And he'd probably be good with young children, too.
Yep.
Just from the way I see him handling himself and everything. I think he'd be good with kids, wouldn't you? You'd like to have some kids to run around with and play with, huh? Sure. Besides, maybe another cat. I think I haven't seen him be aggressive towards anybody. Have you?
No.
Okay. So probably another cat would be okay too. Well, thank you, Jason, for being here today.
Absolutely.
Taking time out of your busy socializing schedule.
glad to help anytime.
And we're very happy Winston could be here. So give us a call if you think you'd be interested in Winston or maybe another cat even. Feel free to call us or come by. We are at the PetSmart on Weber Road in Bolingbrook. We are there on Sunday afternoons from 1 to 3 and Wednesday evenings from 5 to 7. You can come by anytime you like that PetSmart is open and see the cats in the adoption center, but you cannot go in there unless we are there during adoption hours, okay? If you want to actually handle any of the cats there, you have to come by during adoption hours. So, all right. Well, thank you again for being with
us. Absolutely. My pleasure.
And thank you for watching, and don't go away because this is the first day we're showing kittens, and we'll be right back with you. Now we'd like to introduce to you, to the viewing audience of Humane Haven's TV show, The first of our kittens of this spring, of this is June of 2017. And we have, I think we figured out between Kathy and I, over 20 kittens at this point. But we have a number of them here today, and we want you to meet them. We want you to see who they really are. So, Kathy, you've been raising these babies. Why don't we start with you?
Okay.
Who do you have there?
I have JoJo. This is the only male out of this group.
Okay.
He's pretty much all black, and he's got the best eyes. They're kind of bluish green. I don't know how much his eyes are going to change at this point.
Mm-hmm.
He's about 9-10 weeks old.
Okay.
And
is he a short hair or no?
He's got almost medium hair.
Yeah.
But his sisters, I think, might have a little bit longer hair.
Okay.
He's very sweet. When we're playing in the bedroom, he's the first to crawl in my lap and lay in my arms.
How nice.
Of course, though, like all kittens, he likes to play, too. So when he sees his siblings playing around, he goes down to play with them, too. But out of the group, he seems to be the most cuddliest at this point.
Oh, how nice. Oh, he's a sweetheart. Look at him.
They're all so sweet.
They are. They really are. Okay, now, Carol, who do you have?
Who do I have?
Lucy.
Lucy.
Oh, I have Lucy.
Okay.
And Lucy has gray-green eyes. They're beautiful.
Oh, yes, they are. Wow.
And she's got a little white on her nose and a little white on her foot, and she's kind of a long hair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she is. Wow.
And now, she is very sweet.
Yeah. When were these cats born, Kathy, about? April 1st is what we decided,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, April 1st, I believe, is close.
Yeah. So they're, you know, like 2 months old now. And now, before we get any further about that, I want to introduce you to the kitten that I'm holding. And who do I have now, Kathy?
You have Jude.
I have Jude. Okay, this is another little girl. And she is definitely at least medium hair, isn't she?
Yeah.
She's got lots of longer fur.
Medium to long.
Medium to long, yeah. Yeah. But she's basically black, except she has a tummy spot. A white spot on her tummy, don't you?
And she has those same gray-green eyes.
Yes, she
pretty
does.
Eyes.
Aren't they pretty? Yeah. Kittens, eye color changes. They're born with blue eyes, usually, I guess. But their eye color changes at about 7 weeks. So if you see a kitten that doesn't have blue eyes anymore, it's over 7 weeks old. But now, these little babies, they love to play together. They are one litter, these three, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and Kathy can tell us because she raises these kittens for us. But anyway, okay, so we have three babies here. Now, what else can we say about these three babies?
They're way sweet. They're so sweet.
Yes, they are. Yes.
You
they
are
play
just
well
a
together.
Sweet girl.
They should not be an only pet in the household unless you're home 24/7 because it's not fair to them. They need entertainment.
Yes, they definitely enjoy each other's company or a lot of attention.
Okay.
And
so,
this one's been purring. I can't hear
really?
It as much as I can
feel it. The vibrating. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Now, what kind of food are we feeding these babies, Kathy?
They're getting dry science diet and
okay.
fancy feast kitten food. The turkey, not the fish.
Okay. Okay. So that's what they're growing up on. That doesn't mean you can't change their food if you decide to adopt one, but at least for the time being, they should remain on that food for a while until we know for sure that they're doing well on that food, that they continue to do well even with new surroundings. Okay? So they are all so sweet.
Oh, they're so sweet. And for little babies that have never done this before, they're certainly calm and nice.
Oh, they are. Yes. Now, we are showing them at PetSmart. We had them there on Sunday, June 4th, for the first time. That doesn't mean they're ready to go home yet. They're not. We need another 2 weeks before they can be sent home safely. Don't you think, Kathy? Isn't that what we discussed earlier? Yeah. Okay. So, hey, look at you. You are so cute. And you're a snuggler, aren't you? Yes. Okay. So, and if you're thinking about... If you're thinking about getting a kitten because you have an older cat, that's fine. We will suggest that you set up what we call a safe room, one room with a door where the kitten can't get out or other cats or other animals cannot get in. But it has to have the litter box, food, a place for them to sleep. And you need to go in there and handle them and play with them. They need to have toys. What am I missing, Carol?
Well, they need some stimulation. They just
absolutely
need toys they can chase and drag around, and they just need a little stimulation, and they'll grow up and be beautiful cats. These cats are gorgeous.
Yes, they are. They really are. Now, these three came from the same litter. Is that correct,
yes,
Kathy? So we know for sure that they're related.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Hey. Hey,
Good
little
brother.
One. Okay. Now, should you think about volunteering, yes, you might be able to come in and take care of these kittens for us.
Oh, volunteering is so much fun.
You have a good time, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, I do.
Now, you're a socializer like Jason
yeah,
before you
and,
is.
And I'm a feeder, and I'm whatever needs to be done.
Okay, so but tell us, what kind of things do you do?
Well, I take, when we have kittens, I take them out and sit on a chair and let them crawl all over me.
Oh, how nice.
And they're so sweet, and they're such good little cats. They're
yeah,
just wonderful. One Aww, is better than the other. My shoes are squeaking on the
That's
floor.
Okay. That's okay.
They're just good little cats.
Yeah.
They're so much
uh-huh,
fun. And I just like to take them out and watch them.
Okay.
Watch them run, watch them play.
And they run all over?
All over.
They get up high, too?
Some of them.
Okay.
You can't walk on the floor. You have to shuffle, because if you pick up your feet, you're bound to step on somebody.
Oh, my
so
goodness.
So you got to kind of shuffle around the floor while they're out.
Okay. Now, I think the most we have in one cage is six. Is that correct?
Right.
Okay.
Six and a mama.
Six and a mama. Right. Yeah. But, but if you decide you want to come and volunteer, it could be that you'd be taking care of these kittens or something very similar to them. Or maybe there won't be any kittens when you're there.
And then
you know,
we'll have lots
kittens
of cats
are seasonal.
Yes, and then we'll have, and this is the season.
This is. But we do also have adult cats, as you saw. We have Winston, and he's a wonderful cat. He
oh,
really
he's
is.
Pretty and shiny. And
yeah, yeah, and he's boring. Great to handle too. Yeah. Huh. And then there's you. Yes, these kittens are all darling. So, if you're interested in meeting the kittens, come in on Sunday only. We will not have kittens right now at PetSmart on Wednesdays. They will be there on Sundays only from 1 until 3. Come in closer to 1 o'clock because we're going to be out of there at 3 o'clock. And if you really want to meet a kitten and handle them, you're going to have to be there, I'd say, no later than about 2 or 2:15. Especially if there's people ahead of you in line waiting to meet kittens.
Look at this face.
Oh, look at that. Look at that little
Dude,
white
that's so
face.
Sweet.
Yeah, that little white spot, huh? So come in and see, meet who you would like to meet. You could stop by PetSmart. If it's not a kitten, there are adult cats in the adoption center right now. You can stop by there and see who the other cats are, and maybe you'll have a better idea of who you want to come in and meet. And we encourage you to come in because you do have to handle them. You have to know what they're really like before you can say, I want to adopt that cat. Okay? All right. So we're going to stop this segment with these three. We'll be back in a minute with another couple of kittens. Now we want you to meet two more kittens. And these boys, they're both boys, right, Kathy?
Yes.
Okay. These boys are gorgeous. Not that the other ones weren't, but these boys, I think, are very sweet. What do you think? Carol, what do you think of this kitten
I
that you're holding?
These two are special.
Okay.
He just purrs so loud.
Yeah.
Listen.
I can hear him.
I'm going to put him near your mic.
Oh. Everybody can hear a kitty purring, I hope.
Yep.
Anyway,
and
what's his name?
This is Remington.
Okay. And is he short? Kind of medium, maybe?
Kind of little medium. He might grow up to be a silky cat, but he's sure sweet, and he sure purrs. He's a happy little boy.
Okay. Now, Kathy, who do you have there?
This is Sergeant Pepper.
Okay. Oh, he's a long hair, isn't he?
Yeah, he's got lots of hair.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now, that's a male.
Yes.
And what can you tell us about his personality?
He's very playful with the other kitties. He could be a little bit rambunctious, but he's shyer than Remington is.
Okay.
Remington is a little more outgoing than Sergeant Pepper is.
Okay.
Sergeant Pepper is a little more cautious.
Okay.
But he is definitely very sweet.
Okay. That's good.
He's going to grow up to be a big boy. He's got
yeah, don't you think? Because they're about the same age, but he's a bigger body already.
No, he's 2 weeks older. Remington
oh,
is
Remington.
At least 2 weeks
Remington
older.
Remington is 2 weeks older than
yeah.
him?
He's going to be a big boy.
He's going to be a big boy.
Yeah, look he's growing
the,
quickly.
Look
yes.
at the size of his feet and the size of his head.
I know.
You're going to be
I
a
know.
Big boy when you're through.
Oh, say, don't talk about my feet.
Okay, now Remington and Sergeant Pepper play together?
Yes.
And do they behave?
No. Remington can be a roughneck. Uh-huh. He's very rambunctious. He loves to play, but he gets carried away. And Sergeant Pepper, out of this group of kiddies, is the only one who can keep up with playing with Remington.
Really?
Yes. Everybody else hides from him.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. Okay. Now, I hope people at home, I hope you're getting a good close-up view of these kiddies right now. I'm going to grab some toys.
So I don't think if somebody adopting Remington had somebody older that wasn't into playing, that Remington might make that cat very unhappy.
Okay.
But anybody who's very playful, he's forever on the move.
Okay, I can see that.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah. Now, do you have them in a crated?
Yes, they're crated, but they're out during the day, too.
Okay, okay.
Remington always gets in trouble, and he's always the first one put back away.
Okay. Remington, you are something else. Here, you want a mouse?
But he is. He's sweet. He's very playful. He's just a little bit rough.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he scares the other kittens?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well,
but the other group is a little more mild than
this one?
Yes.
Okay.
He sure is a happy purring cat.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's very happy, very playful, very rambunctious.
Mm-hmm.
And he is very pretty.
Yes, he is. He is, and he's very, very nice, aren't you? Look at you. Look at that.
I'm very sweet.
And he has a personality to match, I think. I really do believe that.
And he has a spotty tummy that's
so
cute.
Oh, look at that. Yes.
Yeah, spotty tummy, and it's
yeah,
so
we're showing
cute.
Off your tummy. Look at that.
And yeah, if you rub my tummy, I'll purr more.
He's got a real motor.
Anyway,
so now one other thing I want to mention to you. If you are looking for a kitten and you have young children in the house, we recommend no kittens under the age of 6 months if you have children under the age of 6 years. They can hurt each other. The kittens can hurt the children, and the children can hurt the kittens. And so it's 6 months and 6 years, okay? If you really want to get a kitten, you should have children that are at least 6 years of age. All right, and we're sticking to that because we don't want the kittens to be injured, and we don't want the children to be scratched or bitten or anything else. And kittens are very good at doing that kind of stuff, aren't they, Kathy?
Yeah,
for sure.
Carol?
Yep.
Zip, zip. There we go. So those are the rules of our shelter. It may not be of other places, but those are the rules of Humane Haven because we're protecting your children as well as our kittens. Okay? All right. So for right now, this is Remington, and this is
Sergeant Pepper.
Okay. And if you're interested in either of these, you can call us or you can come in Sundays between 1 and 3 to meet kittens. They will not be there on Wednesday evenings. All right. You can still come in and fill in an application if you want, but you will not get to see them in person unless you're there on Sunday afternoon. Okay. Thank you, ladies, very much. And we're going to move on to another big cat.
Okay.
Now, Judy, this is kind of funny. We have a cat here that is a big boy, right?
Yes.
Okay.
But
he's only a little over a year old.
Yeah, so he may going to get a little bigger even.
But not too much.
No.
Not too much. But compared to those kittens that we had, he's enormous.
Yes, he is giant.
Yes.
He's not just a handful, he's like three handfuls.
Yes, exactly.
But look at him.
Isn't he the sweetest?
That's the difference between the kittens. He is almost perfect already.
Yes.
So he is already ready. You know, you don't have to worry about, you know, climbing up the...
Right, or ages of your kittens or your kids, pardon me.
Right.
Or even of other kittens.
Right.
Or what have you, yeah.
Yes.
He's a wonderful cat.
It's a solo.
Yes, and he's a great tabby.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't know a lot about him. He was, I guess, a stray picked up outside, which is sad.
But what we do know is that he is a very calm cat.
Mm-hmm.
He loves snuggles. He loves to be petted.
Yes.
He loves to be around you. So he would be okay either as a single
animal, or, I mean, he would be fine with other animals too, because we had him out before mm-hmm. with others, and he did just fine.
Yeah.
Solo seems like one of these cats, like, okay, I fit in.
Yeah.
You know, wherever.
Look at that. Look at that pretty pink nose, too. Mm-hmm. Can you see that? Oh, he's
see,
darling.
See how he is? Like, you can, it's like a show cat.
Yeah, he is. He is. He's just handsome.
Yes, he is.
I'd say beautiful, but it's a boy, so he's handsome. Huh.
Yes.
Yes.
He's looking right at the camera.
Yes.
See? Like,
and he
please,
does play with toys on occasion.
Please adopt me.
Yes. Turn around. Can you turn around so everyone can see your
there
pretty
you
face?
Oh, look how pretty.
Yes.
Let everybody see how pretty you are.
Yes, definitely.
Wonderful.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So this is Solo, and he, what do I say? I don't know. He's just a really good cat.
Yes. He has his markings. I like it. It's like his coat is like very, you know, it's... Not the regular tabby's, the gray,
yeah.
ashy.
Right.
I don't know. It looks, it's beautiful. Look at his tail.
Yeah. Now, you volunteer. Oh, whoops. Nope. You're going to stay
I
here,
got
baby.
You
volunteer with us at the shelter.
I do. Yes.
And you feed cats?
I feed the cats. I make sure that their litter boxes get clean and their cages are bleached and that
okay.
they have a very safe and clean Oop. Environment, yes.
yes.
And I do. We do socialize. So we
oh.
pick them up and
hug them and all that stuff. Sometimes.
Yeah, it depends. You know, sometimes. But you know what? That's the best part. You get in there and you say good morning, and they all greet you.
Oh, they do.
And then you know who is here or who is new, and we just pick them up and learn about them. And you know, before we clean the cage. Well, just interact with the cat,
oh,
you know?
Sure.
I mean,
sure.
I have a partner
uh-huh.
There that she's very dear to me because she's a very great person and a very good cat. She knows cats.
Oh, yeah.
She knows cats.
Yeah.
So, and we talk about these cats, you
sure.
know? And
sure.
We let them know. We take pictures, sometimes show them
oh,
to
okay.
friends and
right.
say, hey, look what we got.
Yeah.
But it's very, very nice. It's rewarding to do.
Okay. All right. What do we feed the cats over there?
Well, that depends on the age of the cat. So
okay.
Solo, for example, he would get already adult food. So
right.
he would get Science dry food.
Okay.
And he would get a tablespoon of wet food, whatever, you
sure.
know, adult. Mm-hmm. We get, but the kittens, they get, of course, the kitten and the kitten food, dry food, and also wet food. They get a little more because they still have to grow.
Right.
And... yeah, some cats need a different diet,
mm-hmm.
so we if adjust
they're,
if
they're
overweight.
Heavy.
Yes. Or if they have stomach problems.
Oh, that too.
Yes.
Yeah.
So then we are adjusting,
yeah.
you know, so they get treats from the socializers.
Oh, sure.
You know, which is a good thing, and they
yeah.
get handled. So
yes.
fresh water.
Right, right.
Twice a day.
Uh-huh.
You know.
And so because they're being handled every day, too, we know if there's something going wrong with them, right?
Yes, and we communicate between each other. So
mm-hmm.
we have a board where we say, hey, you know, let's say, for instance, Solo was a little weird or a little too quiet, maybe,
yeah.
or has runny,
runny eyes
or something. We
mm-hmm.
make notes, or in severe cases, we give you a call
mm-hmm.
and say, look, we need attention. You know, he
right.
needs more attention, so then he will. We make sure. Yes, because they get this at least twice a day, if not three times a day, somebody around
mm-hmm.
them, we always notice when something's wrong.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, wonderful.
Or when they get better and some don't want to get touched at the beginning and
yeah.
then, oh, no, you know.
No, everything's fine.
Yes, when they get used to shelter life.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, Solo is a doll, aren't you?
Yes.
He's
Look
got
at
beautiful
him.
Green eyes. And a gorgeous pink nose. And if you're looking for a cat and you aren't interested in him, there maybe you didn't hear me right. He's a beautiful cat.
And he hardly sheds, actually. I
yeah,
mean, like,
it's not
really,
bad at all.
It's
not
really
bad.
Not a
yeah.
lot. So,
so come in and meet him.
Yes.
He is at PetSmart. You can see him during the day if you happen to be shopping
yes.
or something.
We'll go
He's
soon.
There.
We'll
He's
go
living
soon.
There right now, and he will be there till he gets adopted.
Yes.
So thank you so,
so
much,
you're
Judy.
You're welcome.
All right.
You're welcome.
Now we have more kittens, need I say that? If you're looking at the show, you see we have totally different looking kittens. And the one I'm holding is a little boy, and his name is Hummer.
Girl.
Girl? We thought it was a boy to start with, didn't we?
Well, it's a
I
girl
think
now.
So, but now it's a girl. It's a girl.
This week.
Yeah.
Never know when
it
we go back, it might change.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
But they're so little sometimes you really can't tell. Okay, this is Hummer, and... She is a girl. Kathy, who do you have?
I have Ford, and I can't remember if Ford is a boy or a girl. I think Ford is a boy.
Okay.
Well, they're all vehicles. They're all named after vehicles, right. And it didn't matter.
Sure.
The sex.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I have Lexus.
You have Lexus
That's
now.
A girl.
That's a girl, right?
According to you, it's a girl,
yeah,
right?
That's a girl.
Okay, that might change. No, it's a,
no, that's a girl.
No, she's girl's
a little,
changing.
She is a little okay. girl.
Hi.
Hi, Lexus.
Look. Aren't they sweet? They're little. They're little. Now, these kittens are just about 2 months old. No. Are
Close.
They?
They were born April 6th.
Okay. All right, so yeah, just two months old. Just. And they're not ready to go home. Okay, but you can certainly come in and meet them on a Sunday afternoon if you would like to and get your name on an application for them. That would be doable. Mm. Okay, now, do they play together?
Yes.
Okay.
Look at Lexus.
And are they good together?
They're all very good. There are six of them from the litter.
Uh-huh.
Well, actually five and one bonus baby, but they've been together their whole lives, and they're very sweet, very playful.
Okay.
Ford out of the group is the most confident. This is our little Ford Explorer.
Okay.
And he's the first one out of the carrier at the vets and the last one to go in.
Okay. Wow. Do they mind going to the vet? They don't know what it's all about
They
yet.
Don't like this traveling thing.
Yeah.
Most cats don't.
Right. Right. Here. Here, you want a mousey or a little ball that makes noise, huh? Okay, so now these are only half of the kittens from a litter. And we didn't have the mom, is that correct?
No, we had his mom.
Oh, that's Sally. I'm sorry, Sally, yeah. I have not met her yet, I don't believe. But anyway, so Kathy raises these kittens, with or without moms, because we do have some kittens that we don't have the mom. It's only because the kittens turned up and that's what we have.
Yeah.
So anyway, but okay, so these babies do have a mom and her name is Mustang Sally. I love the way you name kittens, Kathy.
Yeah, she's listening to
But
you.
They are all as sweet as can be. Now are these, this one, is she medium hair, you think? Or no, are these short hairs?
I would consider them all short
hairs. All short hairs.
Yeah.
Okay. Is mom a short hair then too?
Yes.
Okay, then they're probably all short hairs. Okay. That's good. Okay. Well, she's just clingy here. Are you going to hang on to me here? Huh? Are you? Yeah. Okay, but remember the rules. Children must be 6 years of age or older to have a kitten of this size. Or even a little bigger because these babies are awfully small. And they have very, very sharp nails.
Yeah.
We've all felt them,
yes,
I'm sure.
Yes, we did.
Okay, I'm going to get down. Got to put you down.
And it's really easy to miss them, you know, when they run around. You can easily, you know, kids, they are not as careful, so easily step
sure.
on them and hurt them. So that's why we say,
six
you know,
months
yes.
and 6 years. Yes, definitely.
Oh, look
definitely.
At these two.
Yeah, yeah. They're really sweet kittens. They get along together. If you're thinking of adopting two from the same litter would probably be a good idea.
Yeah.
Don't you think, Kathy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, look.
Look at them.
They're buddies.
They
yeah.
should have somebody to play.
Yeah.
When they're this little, they need somebody.
Yeah, definitely. No, you stay over there, okay? Could you?
So oh,
probably
is
not.
Having
Lexus
fun time
likes
here.
The mouse.
Yes.
See? I think they all like toys at this age.
Oh, yeah.
Do they? Yes. Okay.
Yeah, they're very curious, very playful.
Okay.
This is the sweet group. They're very sweet.
Okay, all of them.
Yeah.
Okay. You'll be meeting more of them in a minute, but anyway, so I want to go over these names again. You can't. Oh.
I have Lexus.
Sorry. You have Lexus. You have.
I have Ford. The
Ford.
Explorer.
Okay, and I have Hummer here. So if any of these are appealing to you, try to remember the names because when you see them all together, it'll be hard to figure out. Okay, so, we have three more kittens from the same litter we're going to show you in a minute. So hang on, don't go anywhere. All right, this is the other half of the litter that you saw a couple minutes ago. And they really are all different kittens, but they're from the same family, right, Judy? Well, we'll get to that one in a minute, but who do you have?
I have Bentley here.
Okay.
So since we are with the cars, so
yes.
this is Bentley.
Okay, and Carol, who
I
do
have
you have?
Diesel.
Diesel, okay.
Not Vin Diesel, but just Diesel.
Diesel, okay. All right, and Kathy?
I have Mac.
Okay, now Mac looks different than the others. He's different colors.
Yes, he is.
And why?
Mac actually isn't from the litter. He was found in somebody's garage when he was just born, and his mother left him.
Oh.
And he was getting cold, and they were worried about him. Aunt Mustang Sally was happy to add him to her group.
Wow. So she already had five kittens, but she took him anyway.
Yes.
She said, I have one more room for one more.
Yeah, yeah, right. Boy, is he a lucky little guy.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, because once they start getting cold, you have to warm them up quick, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah. Look at that. And he looks totally different than the others because there are no black and white kittens except for him.
And see, I got pretty bottoms of my paw. They're nice and black.
Oh.
And paw prints.
And he has a pink tummy.
Yes. But often all kittens can look different in the litter because they could have different fathers.
That's the way it works.
Every kitten could have a different father.
They have the same mom, but yeah. Yeah, you have a litter of four kittens, and none of them look alike. So, yeah, and that's because of the dads. They have all these different dads. But anyway, he is a handsome little guy. They all are. They're beautiful.
Yeah, they're all very outgoing, very playful.
Yes, he or she certainly is. Look at that. Oh, my goodness. Oh, now they're in playtime.
Yep.
Yep, this is good.
And he's very busy.
Yes, right. So these kittens are all going to be very busy if you take them home. Aw.
He lost his boy.
They will be very busy in your home. They will need toys to play with. Keep that in mind. Toys are just not another word. They are something that they really need. Whoa.
Yeah.
Here you go.
They're curious.
Yes, they are. They are. Hang on to them, ladies. We don't want to lose them in this big studio. But they are as sweet as can be. So, again, these kittens, we will be bringing them to PetSmart on Sundays only, not on Wednesdays, but on Sunday afternoons between 1 and 3. You can come in and meet them. Now, in the meantime, if there's one that you think, that's the one for me, I've got to have that girl or boy, you can call us and tell us that you're definitely interested in whichever one it is, okay? If maybe Mac appeals to you, and just the way he's behaving, you think that would be a great kitten to have in my home. And that's great. So call us and let us know that you're coming in specifically to meet Mac. You could meet the others as well. But anyway, so we want to know if there are people interested in specific kittens, okay? Now, all right, we have shown you how many kittens today, quite a few. But I want you to know, too, this isn't all.
We have more.
We have more kittens than this. And we will be showing them as each litter gets a little bit older, we'll be bringing them to PetSmart. In the meantime, you are welcome to come in and see who we have there. I can't give you specifics about who they will be or exactly when they'll be there, but come in and look. And if you don't see one this week, maybe next week we'll have a different litter there, and that'll have the kitten that you're looking for. So, ladies, do you want to add anything to what we've said here today?
Sharp claws.
And fun, but it's work. So don't underestimate a kitten.
That's
you
right.
You know, a kitten needs time.
Yep.
And
yep.
attention. So otherwise they get destructive, just like
that's right.
dogs can get and puppies. So
sure.
be
sure.
aware that you need time for a kitten.
Yes, absolutely.
Diesel is very sweet but very playful.
Look at these.
They're twins, right, Kathy?
Yeah, oh, yes.
Look at
those
twins.
Those are the twins.
You could adopt twins.
Yes, yes. So come and meet the kittens. And if you're really serious about adopting them, we'll have an application for you to fill in. Thank you so much for watching today. And, you know, tell your friends and neighbors about the TV show so that maybe they'll want to take a look at the kittens and find some that they might be interested in meeting and adopting. We'd like to get these babies out into their homes before they grow up. And that's going to take some work. So if you can help us out by talking to your friends and neighbors and relatives and whoever else, that would be great. Okay? And we look forward to seeing you next time when we will have more kittens, different kittens to show you on For the Love of Animals.
Don't forget, if you lose your pet, to contact your local authorities immediately. They can help your pet find its way safely home. And remember, a pet is not a toy. It's a lifelong commitment. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next show. Bye-bye.
Bye.